Google Merchant's incorrect price and availability error. What can you do to resolve this error? In this video, I'm going to explain exactly why this error is showing up in your Google Merchant and how can you resolve it so your products can start showing up correctly on Google Shopping and you can start getting free traffic or start running Google Ads. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps small businesses and online stores get more traffic and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. If you're new to my channel, you might want to check out my other videos that's actually causing your Google Merchant's account to be suspended due to misrepresentation of self and product. You can check out the videos right here. The link is on the top right hand corner of the screen, so do check that out. One of the things that Google really values is to provide a great experience for shoppers and users. Their ultimate goal is to go head on head with Amazon. So they want users or buyers in the future, if they want to buy something, they will think, okay, I'm going to go to Google Shopping and check out all the products instead of going to Amazon. So in order to achieve that goal, Google strives very hard by setting very stringent guidelines on what merchants are supposed to do for their products and store, how they should present their store, how they should present their products, and to make sure all these products have the correct information, accurate information that's being listed on Google Shopping. And so that's one of the reasons why you might be watching this video today. That's because you have an issue with the pricing and availability of your products. That means somehow or other, the product information that's showing on your store, whether you're running the Shopify, WooCommerce, BigCommerce, Magento store, products that's showing there, and the information that's flowing to Google Merchant Center account, that's incorrect. There's some inconsistency or the pricing is wrong. So the worst thing that can happen is if you're having a lower price on Google Merchant Center and somehow when the users click on it, the prices go up when they go to a store. It's definitely a no-no for Google. Your products could be disapproved of that because of this mismatch of pricing. Or if a user clicks on a certain product, they go to your site and you say that it's not available. And then on Google Shopping itself, it's available. That's a huge issue for Google, and Google sees that as a no-go for your product. So to make sure none of this happens, so if in reality your products really run out of stock or you decide to change your pricing for certain products, maybe for a certain period of time or permanently, whatever, you want to make sure that this pricing is actually synced up. So there is a setting in Google Merchant Center account itself that you can enable a particular setting. When you go to the settings on the top right hand corner of the page, you click on that and then that will show up and you select the pricing to be automatically updated if you change it on your store. So in this case, if you have a automated feed set up, there's automated feed from Shopify or WooCommerce, so this information automatically flows through, then if Google spots a difference in the pricing, they will automatically correct it for you on the Google Shopping to make sure that we are setting the customer's expectations right. So once you've got that set up, that's cool. And then you might ask, what if you decide to have sales, different sales dates? Different periods of the year, maybe 2 to 3 times of the year, you want to run a special sales price. So during that time, the sales pricing needs to be lowered down. So what you can do is you can use these two attributes called sale price and sales price effective date. So you update these two attributes. So you make sure that you set up when the sales price is going to start taking place, from when to when, and then you put the special pricing there, and during that period, then Google will update the pricing to the lower price that you have provided. So let's say if you decide to change your pricing 3 times in a year, then you don't have to worry about Google Merchant Center because you would have already set up a supplementary feed. This is something you can do. You can either set it up on a Shopify or WooCommerce itself, or you can set up a supplementary feed. Basically, you feed this information into Google to tell them for this period, please change the pricing to this date. I'm going to show you how to set it up precisely. You can create this as a CSV file and then you can add it as supplementary feed matching the Shopify ID itself so they can match it to the correct item and these prices will be lowered accordingly when the time comes. Okay, let's head on to my computer and I'll quickly show you how you can do that.
To set up the sales price for the effective dates, This is what you need to do. You need to create first a CSV file. I've opened up a Google Doc to show you how this can be done. Basically, you need three columns in your CSV file. First is you need the ID, which is the Shopify ID for each of your products that can be found in your Google Merchant Center account. And you need to put the sales price for which you want the sales price to be. In this case, let's say you want the sales price for this particular product to be 80. That's the column name, sales underscore price. This is the correct name that's only recognized by Google Merchant. So when you upload your file, you need to have this particular column name stated correctly, the column name ID, sale underscore price, and sale underscore price underscore effective underscore date. So that's the attribute name for the dates which you're going to put in, that's going to be for the sale. Let's say you want to run the sales price between June 1st, 2022 to 30th of June 2022. Put in the time range, which is, okay, which is the example I've already listed out for you right here. This is what you're going to put in. That's the sales price effective date range. June 1st/, that's meant to say to. So from June 1st to June 30th. That's how it's going to be put in. If you have a specific time zone, then this is where this example will be coming in. I'm going to explain this one. So this example is basically for a time zone. If you want to list the sales price to start from a certain time on a certain date, this is the exact format. So this is only the date. So if you want to put in the specific time as well, you need to put in a capital letter T. Then you put in the hour and then you colon the minutes and the seconds if you want to. And then you put in the time zone at the end. So let's say if you are based in Canada, you would be minus 050. So the time would look like that. Let me show you the example I've listed out. So that would be, if you don't list the time, so that will be UTC time. You will start exactly at 12 to 12. So that'll be June 1st to 30th. That'll be in default UTC time zone. If you want to have a different time zone, then you probably need to look at Canada time zone, which is minus 0500. So at the end of the time, you would also put in the time zone, which is plus or minus 0, and then the time zone difference. So you put in that, and of course you put in the forward slash as well. That is the 2, that represents the 2. So from 9 o'clock on June 1st in Canada time zone to 30th of June. Oops, hang on a moment. So 30th of June, as you can see, to 23:59 in the Canada time zone. That's exactly what you'll put in, and then you can copy and paste this particular time zone right here. You're going to put it here and you will have everything there. So this is the file that you're going to submit up to Google Merchant Center. If you have different products, you can list it down and then the price and then the dates as well. Once you've listed there, then you will actually download it as a comma separated values.csv file. Okay. Save that, and we're going to use this to upload as a supplementary feed in Google Merchant Center. So bear with me. Now we are at Google Merchant Center. Click on Feeds. And as you can see here, you have your primary feeds already set up, which is your feed with all the product value or information that you have pulled from either Shopify or WooCommerce store or your other online platforms as well. And now you want to add a supplemental feed. Basically, it means it's a secondary data source to provide additional attributes to your primary feeds. In this case, you want to put in sales price for different periods. You want to match it to certain products that are having a sale. When you have the sale price listed as well on Google Shopping, there will be a sale tag that's tagged next to your product. You will click on Add Supplemental Feed over here. And you give it the name that you want. You can say sale pricing. That would be the feed, to give it a good name. You can either choose to link it directly to Google Sheets. If you click on this option, you can click on continue and it will ask you to log into your Google Merchants account. So ideally, if you have created your Google Sheet as what I've shown earlier, you create it using the same email address that you have chosen to create this Google Merchants Center as well. So you will sign in and then you will link to that sheet. However, if you don't want to use this file that you're going to maintain, you can also choose a different one, which is to upload like the CSV file that we have created earlier. You select upload, you continue, you type in the name of the file, and you can upload the file from your computer. And then once you continue and save, and that's it. So you just need to complete step one, step two, and step three. If you have set up to extract individual attribute values for each of your feed as well, go to the primary feed and select the particular attribute and choose to extract this attribute. So you automatically extract it from the file that you have uploaded. And that's it.
Okay, I hope that was useful for you. Now you know how to make sure that the prices and availability stays consistent throughout the entire time. No mismatch price and availability anymore. And also to make sure that Google Shopping always has the sales price updated as well. So that's all settled. And if you're also facing other issues on Google Shopping, on setting up with the correct product identifiers, MPN or GTIN error that you have, you can check out my other video right here where I explain to you why you have this problem and how you can resolve it, especially if you produce your own products. And if your account is still unfortunately facing suspension, you can also check out my other video on suspension and how to reinstate your account. My other video right here, link is on the top right hand corner of the screen. And if you have a website needs improvement error, you can also check out my other video where I list down all the improvements you can make to your site to make sure it adheres with Google's guidelines. And if you're facing some other errors that I have not named in this video yet, you can check out my entire Shopify playlist where I list down different ways to resolve those errors that you face so you can quickly get your products approved in your account, reinstated as soon as possible if you're facing those issues. If you don't have your product feed set up in an automated manner to make sure it's refreshed, please do that. I highly recommend you to set it up. It's a very easy setup. And once you have everything all set up and you're ready to start driving more traffic to your store, you could also check out my other video right here on how to drive more traffic to your store without running ads if you're intimidated or overwhelmed by the idea of running ads, where I discuss all the different ways you can drive traffic to your store, the pros and the cons, how long is it going to take you to see the results, and how difficult it is to set things up. So do check the link out and download my Shopify marketing guide. And also, if you find all of this too overwhelming and you need guided one-on-one support, I also help store owners to get more traffic and sales as well. So do check out my link in the description and pinned comments. Check out my services page on how you can work with me to grow your store. And if you enjoyed this video, found it informative, useful, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss future videos on how to get more traffic and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI Doctor, signing off. See you in the next video. Bye.